They sent someone to move the architectural plans. Do you have them?
Did they hurt you?
I'm fine.
Let's go.
What about the plans?
The plans are lost. Just concentrate on escaping, please. Get Miss Nightingale to look at that. I must find the vault before Starrick secures the shroud.
We'll talk to the Maharaja again.
I will talk to the Maharaja. You will get your head looked at.
I'm sorry my capture hasn't done your plans.
You'd be safer on the train.
Even if you find the vault, you can't just walk into Buckingham Palace alone.
I won't be alone! I'll see you back at the train, Mr. Green.
This is in the old city. You have a pleasant day now.
All right, B. Who are you and what's your game?
Oh.
it isn't my dear old
shell gate for you. Press that shit up for you.
Well, if it isn't my dear old chum, Mr. Disraeli. Now, Prime Minister, which of your friends is about to stab you in the back?
The Corrupt Practices Bill is a vital step in reforming our government. If the majority party is allowed to dictate the results of contested elections, we can scarcely call ourselves free.
If we yield up our rights bit by bit to the courts, we can scarcely call ourselves free, sir.
This is so like you, Gladstone. You would rather throw your body upon the gears of progress than surrender one iota of power.
By God, Disraeli, you are a fool. I'll not stand idly by and watch you drag parliamentary privilege through the muck.
No, certainly not. You'd rather return us to the yoke of tyranny. Perhaps while we're at it, Mr. Gladstone, we could repeal Magna Carta and return the crown to the bloody Stuarts.
Merely because I do not wish to see government placed in the hands of judges, you would make these slanderous accusations? I'll not stand for it!
Then I shall obviate the requirement. Good evening, sir.
I presume. Pleasure to meet you. B,
my name's Herbert.
Then why are you following the Prime Minister?
It's just a job, sir! Some old bloke paid me to...
Smug bastard.
Bloody hell! Where did you come from?
Well, I was born in Crawley, but that's by the by. Who are you working for?
I never got his name. Old chap, big moustache, wore some kind of uniform. Who's ours, maybe?
What's his game?
Please, you'll kill me.
And a three-story drop will shatter your legs and send you to the workhouse. Difference is, you can run from him.
Tomorrow! My lads are going to attack the Prime Minister's carriage on the way to Parliament.
Perfect.
Very well, you've won. I'll not fight you any longer. Do you hear me? Do as you like. Just leave me in peace. If you're going to kill me, get on with it. I'll not cower. No more, no more. I'm not dying here, not like this. Do as you like. I'm not going to hinder you any longer. Well, I salute your superior skill. Very well, you've won. I'll not fight you any longer. Do you hear me? Do as you like. Just leave me in peace.
Thank you.
So much for the house call. I have to find a way into that carriage.
Prime Minister,
I'm your new bodyguard, Jacob Fry.
I wasn't informed of any new bodyguard. Who's your commanding officer?
Let the boy speak, Dizzy.
Madam, apologies, but we've learned of a threat on your life. And the Met thought it best to move quickly.
Threat? What sort of threat?
That sort. If you excuse me a moment.
So fast, Your Excellency.
Steady on. That's the way.
Get Roger!
Doing fine. Let's go. Walk on, girl.
Hey! Get back here with that Prime Minister!
That's a girl. Easy!
seem to have come through unscathed.
Walk on, girl.
You have our thanks, Mr. Fry.
That's a girl.
It was Gladstone. I bet my life. This is perfectly achieving this distinct lack of character.
Show yourself, Gladstone! Show yourself, you feckless muck snipe!
Well, he's probably going to be in the band with a fracture of disease.
That bloody man! He will pay for this!
Thank you. What do you intend to do about Gladstone, young man?
I assure you, madam, Gladstone is innocent in this.
But he tried to kill my husband.
Well, we'll look into Gladstone. Perhaps you can help me with another inquiry, madam. A gentleman with ties to Parliament, older, wears cavalry uniforms and has a large mustache.
You seem like a rough-and-ready sort of fellow, Mr. Fry.
Well, yes, I am, actually.
And are you familiar with the poorer districts of our city?
Roughly.
Wonderful. As it happens, I've been eager to tour the Devil's Acre. If you were to escort me, I'd be happy to assist you in your inquiry.
That strikes me as a dangerous idea.
Then it's settled. Come back here to Downing Street tomorrow night, 8 o'clock sharp. Good day, Mr. Fry.
But I...
Good day, Mr. Fry!
Thank you.
Madam?
Mr. Fry.
Ready to take the air? Devil's Acre should just be coming alive.
I'm afraid I must cancel our engagement. The lawn is crawling with scandal-hunting journalists, and I simply cannot be seen in the company of someone so...
I'll see them off.
You follow along when it's clear.
Yes, yes. Be gentle, won't you? The press are notoriously touchy about any violence to their person.
I'll barely ruffle a hair on their heads.
Shh, Desmond.
That's yours, if you can get those chaps over there to follow me.
Right you are, sir.
Blimey! Look! It's Squire Bancroft!
Best lead them astray before they tear me to shreds.
Mr. Bancroft! Mr. Bancroft! What's coming up next for the Prince of Wales?
Will you be performing Mr. Robinson's new work?
Who will you be playing?
Any comment on the notices for the play?
young man. Busy ought to keep you on to deal with the liberal.
Steady on. Let's go.
In the car, it's the Prime Minister's wife.
Well done.
I really must not be seen here, Mr. Brown.
Fine, girl.
What a rough place. Give me your arm, Mr. Fry. Let us see what the Devil's Acre has to offer.
Is your dog quite all right?
Oh, Desmond's fine. He's just not overfond of strangers. Or cats. What awaits us deeper in the acre?
Charming dog.
Grab him! Drag him out! Time to set you gone!
Did I say that properly? Well done, Mr. Fry. Have you considered taking employment as a parliamentary whip? Hush!
Thank you.
Oh, Mr. Fry, look at those two.
Yes, they seem to be,
I've been married twice, Mr. Fry. I'm fully aware of what they're doing. God bless them.
What sort of meat is that man selling?
Best not to ask.
Why? Is it something dreadful? Is it rat?
I don't mean to be indelicate, given the present company, but another name for it is Bow Wow Mutton. Here we are, the old one.
So this is a pint, is it? Remarkable.
Nice doggy.
Hand over the mutt.
You'll change your tune when me and my friends find you.
Now then, Desmond, to get you back to your mistress, whom I've just left entirely unattended in one of London's most dangerous pubs.
Well, if you never told your father how you felt about him, how was he supposed to know?
I never thought of it that way. I suppose deep down we all just want to be loved.
Just so. Here, have a sweetie. Oh, Desmond and Mr. Fry, I'd like you to meet... Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name.
John the Tosser.
Charmed. I think we better get you home.
Right you are, Mr. Fry. Come along, Desmond.
Well, well, well. If it isn't the dog walker.
Now, let's not do something we'll regret. Your stop, madam.
My stop. How delightful. Thank you. Thank you for a splendid evening, Mr. Fry. I shall be sure to speak highly of you to Dizzy. Oh, yes.
What's this nonsense about needing a password to see Lord Cardigan today?
Relax. I've got it in my pocket.
Look sharp, men. Allow no one past unless I authorize them.
Cardigan has gone too far this time. I've a mind to contact Scotland Yard myself.
Come now, gentlemen. I thought us united in opposition against this perfidious law.
I hope everything was to your satisfaction.
Nothing but the highest quality goods. Look for yourself.
Bleeding sick of it all, of course. We're knocking you over. Next time, I'll just stay down and sleep.
Pardon me, gentlemen. Sergeant Freddy Abeline of Scotland Yard. Where might this scandalous activity be taking place?
Oh, yes, yes. It's, just this way. Follow me, Sergeant, but discreetly, if you would. One doesn't like to be seen airing a fellow member of Parliament.
I'll be very discreet. Usually I would be in disguise, but my clothes all fell into the Thames. One of my favorite disguises is a very ancient old lady, modeled after my mother. You'd be surprised how convincing I am. A tough old bird she was. Actually had a facial hair problem. We'd sell the hair for dolls. Please let me know if I'm speaking too much. I am prone to flights of fancy.
Password.
Balaclava.
Come in.
Ah, Minister Hacker. Now then, let's discuss this like Good God! Who the bloody hell?
Oh, shut up.
Should fall not on the gloried fields of Crimea, but to an assassin's blade in the very halls of power.
Are you finished yet?
Take your bow, knave, for you have managed what no Russian battery, what no Indian tiger could achieve. Claim your trophy, and may you choke on it.
Yes, but do tell me more about Balaclava.
Farewell. Farewell, dear Britannia! Your dawn shall be dimmer that the Earl of Cardigan sees it not. God save the Queen and the 11th Hussars!
What a prick.
Apart from the death squad on our tail, apart from that.
Backup's on the way. Why are you pushing yourself so hard? It's not your job to fight Templars.
I had this colleague. He was our boss's son. I didn't much care for him at the start. Everyone treated him like he was so bloody special. To me, he just wasn't invested in anything that didn't affect him personally. But I was wrong about him. He became my friend. Put himself through hell, and he saved us all in the end. So I reckon, well, I can't apologize to him, but I can, I don't know, I can try and live up to his example.
You are a good assassin.
Holy jeez!
Hello. It has been too long.
Galena! Blimey, I have not seen you since we blew up that lab in Paris.
There were many explosions, and you screamed like a baby.
Bishop tells me Otzelberg is here.
I will kill him for you.
Super. Great news. Now, if you wouldn't mind keeping watch, I am going to lie down and die now.
Rest. We have a big fight coming.
Sean and Rebecca are safe for now, but we're still relying on you to find us that shroud.
A letter? For me? A dinner invitation.
And with whom are you dining this evening?
Maxwell Roth.
The leader of the Blighters? You're not going.
Of course not.